Ah, so many duplicate photos. Good news, everyone. The Mac now has built-in duplicate photo cleaning. So my clients are asking, is macOS Ventura duplicate photo scanner cleaner thing good? Is it worth it? Should they update to Ventura to use it? I'll show you the quick and easy select all and merge all duplicates first, right away. And then later in this video, I'm going to talk about my caveats and the pros and cons. I'll also be making a distinction between actual duplicates, duplicate photos, and similars, similar photos. So on your Mac, just go into the Photos app and then click on Duplicates over here on the left. If you don't see that here, that just means you need to update your macOS to Ventura or later. Also, make sure you do a Time Machine backup before you do that. And you can merge two items. You can merge the groupings little by little yourself. Or if you just go to the Edit menu and then go Select All, it's Command A on the keyboard, then you can say Merge 42 items up in the top right here. I'm going to click that. And now I get this choice between merging 14 exact copies only, and that's the actual duplicates, or merge 42 items, which includes the duplicates and the similar files. So I'm only going to do the exact copies, and I'll talk about similars in a moment. On the iPhone, you just go into the Photos app and then tap on Albums down in the bottom right. Scroll down a ways until you get to Duplicates. And you can go in here, and then here you just tap Select up in the top right, and then Select All up in the top left. And then here you can say Merge down in the bottom middle, Merge All Photos. And this is where it gives you the choice to do exact copies or to merge similars as well. So it's totally good and safe to do the exact copies, and I'll talk more about merging the rest, merging similars. So what merge actually means is that the better photo gets all of the right album and favorites and keyword type info, and the crappier version of the photo goes into the trash, into recently deleted. So if you make a boo-boo, you can pull it out of the trash. Now, in terms of similars, things can get a little bit more tricky. In my photos library, I had some photos showing up in the duplicate section that I did not actually want to merge. I am super picky, however. So let's talk about those pros and cons now. In terms of the pros and cons, I have printed my list. For the pros, it keeps the better, more high-quality file. So if you have an HEIC or RAW image versus a JPEG, you'll be left with the HEIC or RAW image. It handles albums correctly. This is huge. If you have one photo in one album and the duplicate is in a second album, the merged photo will appear in both albums. No other duplicate scanning software does this. The albums are, you don't have to worry about them. The photo shows up in all of the combined albums. It keeps the favorite status. When you put the heart on one of the two photos, then the merged photo will be a favorite as well. It keeps the location and places information correctly, so the merged photo will show up properly on the map. It handles keywords properly. So if you have one photo with one keyword, a second photo with a different keyword, the merged photo will have both keywords, the two different keywords. And the Photos app never modifies the original file metadata. That's true for all the way back to the earliest version of iPhoto. You will never have damage done to your original files. In terms of the cons, merging similar photos is scary if you are picky like me. You also need to update your macOS to the latest, and so make sure you have a backup of your Mac, a Time Machine backup, but that's also scary if you are update averse like me. Some minor date issues. I had some original photos that I sent out via WhatsApp, and they came back into my photo library as a JPEG about 4 hours later, something like that. the merged photo ended up with the later date by 4 hours. I thought it was strange. I hope Apple fixes this. Some similar photos were merged in a way that I did not want. I only had about under 10 out of 1700. I'll show you some examples of that a little bit later in this video. And lastly, if you have similar photos that you don't want to merge, the only way to get them out of that duplicates section is to delete one of the two or to hide them. Select them both and then Command L to hide. So my recommendation, if you are picky like me, is to just merge the exact duplicates first, all at once, and then go through the similars yourself by hand. And your goal is really to confirm the logic and the decision-making of the Photos app. Of course, you can merge small batches at a time, or if you find that you're happy with the decision-making of the Photos app, then you can select all and merge those similars the way I showed you earlier in this video. Now, on the subject of the Photos app making some mistakes in the decision-making, in my Photos library, I had these two flagged as duplicates. This one is the one I would have wanted to keep, and this one here had a red light on, sort of in the foreground, and the Photos app actually chose this one as the one to keep and got rid of this one. So I had to go into deleted items and pull this one out. It also flagged these two photos, a color and a black and white photo, as duplicates, and I would not have wanted those to come up as duplicates because I want to keep both the color and the black and white one. But what you can do if you want to test it for yourself is you can actually put one of these photos into one album. I made an album here called Duplicate Test 1, and then you put the second photo into a second album. And so now in the Dupe Test 1 album, I've got the color version. Dupe Test 2, I've got the black and white version. Let's see what happens when I merge these. I click Merge Two Items, Merge Two Items. So now when I look in Dupe Test 1 and Dupe Test 2, it's the color version of the photo. Not a huge deal because I can make this black and white, and I'm glad that it kept the color version, but still I would not have wanted those to show up under duplicates. So if you want to get through a bunch of similar photos quickly, you can just click on one of the photos and hit the space bar to make it big. And then when you hit the left arrow, it just moves through the photos little by little. So you can go backwards and check them all. So you just click this one, hit space bar to make it big, and then hit the left arrow. And I'm just looking to see if there's any difference between these photos. And I'm seeing that there isn't. And so now, knowing that everything up to here is fine, I can highlight this one, hold shift on the keyboard and highlight this one, and then merge this whole group because I just checked all of them and it went pretty quickly. So maybe you're happy with what you see, or maybe you get tired of looking at it and thinking about it and you say, "F it," and select all and merge the rest. Regardless, I am very happy with the duplicate cleaning software as part of macOS Ventura. I and my team would love to help you with it. If there's anything in this video that you don't understand or is scary or anything like that, we will go through any or all of it with you. Boom! Mac Epiphany. If you found this helpful and you want some private Mac coaching with me or someone from my team, just head to macinhome.com/booking. We work with people all over the world. We'll help you with whatever is on your Mac problems list, and you will never feel judged or shamed for whatever mess you're in. How the f*** do I do the numbers here? Because I actually have 6, and I won't be able to use my left hand because I'm holding the paper.